The tie that binds the communities of Portsmouth, New Hampshire and Kittery, Maine is made of steel and has stretched across the Piscataqua River for nearly a century. Built in 1922, the original World War Memorial Bridge was the brainchild of John Waddell, the father of American movable bridge engineering and one of HNTB's earliest bridge designers. The innovative counterweight and mechanical system Waddell designed for the 1922 Memorial Bridge earned him a patent and gave residents and ship traffic reliable passage for generations.
It is economic, it is recreational, and it is part of the community. It's been here for so long, and it's just such an integral part of the community. It's almost like it has its own soul within the community.
The soul of the community was shut down in December 2010 when it became too unsafe due to extreme corrosion. A team made up of the State Departments of Transportation for New Hampshire and Maine, the Federal Highway Administration, construction contractor Archer Western, bridge designer HNTB, consultant HDR, and fabricator Structal faced challenges in delivering a new lifeline to these communities. Among them, how to accelerate construction to decrease inconvenience to the public, be sensitive to environmental concerns, manage swift currents and heavy waterway traffic, and meet the unique design requirements of movable bridges. For HNTB bridge engineers, that meant living up to the groundbreaking legacy of Waddell.
For me, what Memorial Bridge, the Memorial Bridge replacement, tries to do is it tries to explore new areas in bridge design, and particularly movable bridge design, that hopefully are consequential enough so that they're followed by other designers and used on other projects.
Using a dynamic, collaborative, and pioneering approach, HNTB engineers delivered a new generation of bridge design that reduces fabrication costs and the construction schedule by eliminating gusset connection plates, which corrode and fail, like on the 1922 Memorial Bridge, simplifying the floor framing system, standardizing truss span geometry, employing cold bending techniques and increased bending radii, and fabricating continuous flanges to achieve a particularly robust and redundant truss system. The design plan also protected the riverbed by using the existing piers as cofferdams, and it called for placing the primary and secondary span drive machinery under the bridge.
We bid the job 5 months faster than our competition. And what enabled us to do that was the HNTB structural design was it gave us a faster structure to build in the field.
The team's choice of design build as the delivery method also propelled the project to completion quicker and resulted in a better design. It allowed the final span to be floated downstream and lifted into place in June 2013 and to be open to traffic 2 months later, squeezing the overall impact to the public and businesses down to only 18 months.
I would have to say it is the success of the project from a contractual basis. If we did our standard design bid build process versus design build process, we would not be here where we are today.
It'll be nice to know that the effort from everybody who's been involved, from the tradesmen to the engineers and the managers, that we were able to actually pull this off in a time frame that nobody thought we could do it.
The construction of the new World War Memorial Bridge continues a century of HNTB bridge design excellence, of developing unique site-specific solutions through dynamic interaction with all stakeholders. It is a bridge that focuses on the future with its cost-saving and long-lasting innovations, but with a nod to the past in reconnecting two communities for generations to come.